This was the first 3D printer that I owned, and it was an awful experience. If it went a full day without something going wrong, I'd be amazed. But I made it work. This thing got me through my final year of uni printing robot parts almost non-stop for weeks. But as soon as I could, I upgraded and left it behind. Fast forward 5 years, I now have way too many machines, including a few premium and a few mid-range 3D printers. And it goes without saying that these all smash my budget 3D printer across every category. And that's why I was a bit shocked when I was invited to check out the Longer LK5 Pro, because it's less expensive than all of these, but it also has a few big advantages over my printers that are 5 times the price. So it seems that in the years it's been since I was in the market, budget 3D printers have improved quite significantly, which raises the question, do you even need an expensive 3D printer anymore? Let's start by assembling the LK5 Pro. An immediate takeaway was that this is a really big printer, bigger than anything I own, and it also has a touchscreen, unusual considering that this is a budget printer. I did make some silly mistakes in the assembly livestream that I did, like installing the extruder upside down, but overall, assembly was straightforward. It comes mostly pre-assembled, it's not like a Prusa kit where you need to assemble every individual part. If you pick this as your first 3D printer, I don't think you'll run into any issues when building it that aren't simple to fix. And if you do, well, learning how to troubleshoot a 3D printer is a valuable skill to learn anyway. After assembly, we can run the setup, which includes manual bed leveling. This is one of the trade-offs you make when you buy a budget 3D printer. Instead of an automatic process, you regularly need to ensure that the print bed is as flat as possible by adjusting these screws beneath it. The veterans know what I'm talking about, but if you're new to the hobby and have only seen flashy, expensive 3D printers in YouTube videos, you might not know about manual bed leveling. While it isn't automated, the screen does guide you through the process step by step so that you don't completely lose your sanity. Once you get the hang of it though, it's easy, but it does take some time. Anyway, this is the assembled LK5 Pro. It's a Cartesian i3 bedslinger, whatever you want to call it, style printer, and it's pretty big, with a larger print volume than any of my other 3D printers at 300x300x400mm, and it includes this removable glass print bed. It also has the color touchscreen that I mentioned. We're seeing these a lot more these days, but a lot of mid-range 3D printers still don't have them, so it's crazy to me that these features can be included on a budget printer like this. Because it is a budget 3D printer, we've also got a fairly basic design, but I can't really fault that because it makes repairs and upgrades far easier as all the components are exposed. Like I mentioned, this 3D printer is all about trade-offs, so there's no automatic bed leveling like I mentioned, there's no super high-speed printing, the print bed isn't flexible but it is removable, and of course there's no premium features like a camera or Wi-Fi that would jack up the price. It's just a good old reliable 3D printer, and I'd argue that maybe that's all you need. Cool. So let's do some 3D printing and put this machine to the test. There's some sample filament included, but I'll just be using this marble filament from 3D Fillies instead. To verify I built the 3D printer okay, I first printed my Maker coin. There's a few under extrusion issues on the top layer and some stringing around the outside, but not bad for a test print. The appeal of this printer, of course, is the massive build volume. So I printed these simple trays for my coffee station. So I was originally planning to break it up into 4 smaller parts to print on a different printer, then glue it all together. But with the LK5 Pro, I didn't need to. Now I could have fit both trays into a single print, no issue, but I split it up into 2 so I didn't need to run the print overnight. It's 27x15cm, and as you can see, it took up almost all the length of the printer and wouldn't have fit on any of my other printers. Then I printed this vase by David Kissel, which again would have been way too big for my other printers. It's around 330mm tall. I could have gone all the way to 400mm, but I don't need a vase that big. It was printed using vase mode, so the walls are only 1 layer thick, which does mean it is a bit flimsy, but once it's on a shelf, you're never going to know. The only issue I had was removing it from the build plate. Because it's glass, you can't bend it to easily pop the print off, so I had to get the scraper underneath and carefully pry it up. This was a recurring issue across basically all the prints I did. With glass print beds like this, it does help if you remove the print right when it's done. Otherwise, when the print cools, it really starts to grip the build plate. But I seem to do okay with just brute force. I also had another problem that the LK5 Pro helped me solve. My cat likes sleeping on my shelf here. It's like his little bedroom, so I designed and printed this curtain rod and made some curtains for him. Again, this wouldn't have fit on any of my other 3D printers in one piece, and I think he really likes the extra privacy. I also made these little photo frames for him to liven up the apartment. Yeah, I think he likes it. Overall, I'm really happy with how all these prints turned out. In fairness though, none of them were that complex. So another thing that this printer would be amazing for is for making props for cosplay. Just like this dwarf helmet by Spinozafor that I plan on printing next. This print will take up basically all the print volume and run for days. I haven't done anything like this before, and unfortunately I didn't have time to print it for this video, but please keep an eye out and I'll upload how it turns out. Because this would be for cosplay, it doesn't have to be a perfect print because you'd sand it down a bit and then paint it to get a good finish. So I'll print it at a 0.2mm layer height and then do some optimizations to get it going as fast as I can. Now, cosplay isn't my thing, but I do know that the cosplay and 3D printing worlds have been overlapping a lot more lately. So I know a lot of cosplayers would be very interested in picking up this machine because it's capable of printing things like this helmet in just a single part. This printer has actually been on the market for a while. The pro version is a bit more recent though, and it continues to receive incremental upgrades. Like, the newer version started including a filament guide and a support for the print bed wires in the box. I did run into things that I didn't like with the Longer LK5 Pro. I'm spoiled with auto bed leveling, built-in cameras, amazing flexible textured build plates and Wi-Fi connectivity in my 3D printers, but taking a step back and considering the price point, I can easily excuse the things that I didn't like. Also, I should probably mention, if you wanted to, you can upgrade this printer with auto bed leveling. Longer have guides on their website to walk you through the whole process, but it does require a bit of work. You can also, of course, use different higher quality build plates as well. I highly recommend textured flexible build plates. They're just so much easier to remove prints from. Even without these upgrades though, I have no issue recommending this 3D printer for beginners, or even for more experienced people who just need a larger printer. It's just plain good value. And that takes us back to the question, do you even need an expensive 3D printer anymore? My answer for you is no, you don't. You'll need to put in more work to get good prints, like leveling the bed, transferring files to SD cards, removing prints, and so on compared to a premium printer. But for the sheer amount of money you save, it's a really good trade-off. Companies who manufacture high-end products are always going to tell you that you need a Wi-Fi connected, high-speed, multicolor 3D printer with built-in coffee dispenser because they want to make more money. And I have people ask me all the time, what 3D printer should I get? Expensive 3D printer A or expensive 3D printer B? And sometimes I just have to say, bestie, I appreciate the passion, but maybe you should start on the lower end and get a feel before you work your way up. But please let me know what you think in the comments. The Longer LK5 Pro is almost the same price as my first 3D printer all those years ago, but it's a night and day difference just how much better budget 3D printers, like this one, are today. If you'd rather have the most convenient just press play 3D printer experience possible, yeah, this printer isn't for you. But if you're willing to put in the extra effort to save a lot of money, I think you'll be very pleased with the LK5 Pro.